First up, this video is sponsored by me, and we have some courses over at school.learnlightandsound.com. If you want to learn how to do better lighting or better sound for your video, go ahead and check that out. We'll put a link down below as well. Also, in full disclosure, Instromall gave the Godox ML100Bi to me for free. They have not paid me anything beyond that, and they have not told me what to say, and they have not reviewed this video prior to posting, so all the opinions shared here are my own. Let's jump in. Now, normally for a review, I would go into the pros and cons, and I'll just put that at the end. You can go read that, but let me just kind of touch on some of the highlights here. This is a tiny, tiny little light, 100 watts. You can power it a variety of different ways, even as simply as a USB battery bank, as long as it has PD, power delivery. And it also comes with an AC adapter. What's unique about this light, it's a single point light. So the LEDs, like, it's called a chip on board. It's a chip with LEDs at about that size. Normally that kind of light produces on its own with no modifiers like softboxes or anything else on it, produces pretty hard light. That is to say, the transition from light to shadow is pretty extreme. It's usually like a line. With a softer light, the light tends to wrap around a little bit more, and so the transition from light to shadow is smoother, and it looks better on most people's faces. So unless you're going for a really grungy or gritty kind of look, then usually soft light is what you want on people's faces for video. So this is that type of light, but it comes with a Fresnel lens. A Fresnel lens is a little lens you put on it, and it compresses, it kind of focuses the beam of light that comes out of it. And so what I'm doing is the light is sitting over here, about 2 meters away from me. It's shooting over this way into a white piece of cloth, and that is reflecting all of this light on me. That's exactly what you're seeing here. And the exposure setting we have on our camera to achieve that is f2.8, ISO 800, 1/48th of a second if you're a photographer, or if you're on video, that's at 23.976 frames per second, 180 degree shutter angle. So that's with the light set to 24% on its dimmer, which is amazing. A tiny little light like that can bounce enough light to act as a key light for a talking headshot like this. So the really nice thing about this light is it's tiny, so it can fit in really, really small spaces. It does have two fans in it, and the fans only come on when the temperature internal to the light gets to a certain point. It has not come on yet. But if you're in a warmer room, it's going to come on more often. And it's relatively quiet. It's not super loud. So I would say it passes my soundy test there. I'll go ahead and put the metrics for the light up on the screen here. It is good color. It's decent color quality, I guess I would say. It is not stellar color quality. But for a light in this price range, it usually retails for $180 to $200 US. And I would just say that in this price range is a really, really nice light if you want to do a lighting design like this where you're balancing the light. Now, if you don't have a big piece of fabric like this, not a problem. You can use a poster board or a foam core board. Just set that up at an angle so that it's kind of facing at you. The bigger the better. The bigger it is, the softer the light's going to be in terms of that smoother gradient from light to shadow. And that's what you can get. There are some onboard effects. They're okay. They're not anything outstanding or stellar from what we've seen in other lights like this. And you can also control the light remotely with a Godox light app. I use the one on iOS and it works great. You can control multiple lights with a single app. It reconnects fairly quickly, so they've done a nice job there. It does have a 1-year warranty, and the price at the time of this review is $199 US. Now, this light does not have it has its own proprietary mount for the lenses, and you can buy other lenses. You can buy wider lenses, you can buy soft boxes, you can even buy an adapter that allows you to attach Bowens mount accessories. And Bowens mount accessories are probably the most common types of light modifier accessories out there. Soft boxes, all sorts of stuff. Oh, also this one has an umbrella holder on the little yoke that comes with it, so you can just use an umbrella to diffuse the light. Now with an umbrella, it does produce beautiful soft light. However, it goes every freaking where. So you need to be aware of that. And you're not gonna necessarily get this kind of light on one side, a little bit more shadow on the other side. It's going to be probably very high key, is generally the effect that you get with that, generally. When I say the color quality is not perfect, I wanna say one thing here. When I did the measurements with my Seikonic C800, this light actually came out with a fairly heavy magenta cast to it when I didn't have the lens on it. But when I put the lens on, the color, the magenta cast basically went away. So there's something going on there. That's not a problem. The biggest thing I found is that when I put the lens on and I set the light to its color temperature, so this is a bicolored light. In other words, you can do tungsten color, the kind of orangish light, all the way up to daylight and a little beyond to get a very bluish light. What I found is that when I set it to 5600 Kelvin, which is daylight, I found that the measurement actually came out at 5200 Kelvin. So what it says on the screen is not exactly what you're getting. It's not necessarily a problem. I just set the camera to 5200 Kelvin on my for my particular copy, the light to 5600 Kelvin, and my skin is coming out basically the way it looks in real life. So that's the way you want to probably operate this to get what you want to get. The only other con I could really think of, if we're being nitpicky, is you couldn't really control the fans with different modes. For example, some lights allow you to turn the fans on so they're always spinning slowly and quietly so that the fan doesn't have to kick on once the light gets to a certain temperature. And the fan kicking on, again, these fans are fairly quiet, but it is something that can be noticeable in your audio if you're doing video. So that's one thing to keep in mind. All right, I think that's everything. If you have any questions, go ahead and leave those down below. In the meantime, get out there and make some great lighting designs and some great videos. Talk to you again soon.